now by Andy Gresh on this Patriot playoff bye week. If Bill Belichick has a checklist this week heading into next week once they get their opponent, what are the top couple things on the list?
One, Yianni, is going to be health. Let's get everybody as healthy as we can. Let's come up with a plan, if they already aren't in place, to be able to get guys as healthy as possible. Number two, it's going back to basics, believe it or not. It's not looking ahead necessarily and trying to project who they're going to play, but it's getting back to blocking, tackling, X's and O's, the kind of stuff that you would do at camp just to sort of shore yourself up. And then number three, which actually would be applicable to the playoffs both here and down the road, would be situational football, going over stuff that Bill Belichick thinks they need to go to button up, two-minute drill, goal line situations. Hey, the Patriots at one point this year, Yianni, ran a bunch of people off the field and ran a bunch of people on the field to kick a field goal late at the end of a first half. And that doesn't happen just by going like this. It's because you practice it.
Rank the three possible Patriot opponents in terms of most challenging to least challenging.
Ooh, well, the least challenging is the Bills. I think we know that. I would say that the Titans are just above them. And then Kansas City is the clear winner in this one. They've come here to New England. They've already won a game. They rested their quarterback last week. And, yeah, they're going to play a wild card game against Tennessee, will be the Chiefs. But I fully expect them to handle their business. Look, everybody talks about the luck of New England. We're not going to get lucky enough to have Buffalo come in a divisional round to where we can all take a powder and wait until the AFC championship game. It's going to be someone that could come in here and at least do a little bit of damage.
What is your vibe right now with this team? I feel like they're the best team in the AFC, and the competition isn't quite there other than Pittsburgh, who I think the Patriots would beat. So the Patriots are capable of getting to the Super Bowl, but are they as good as recent incarnations of this team?
Yeah, I mean, we ask this every year, Yianni, and the thing is, do they need to be better than other teams of the past, or do they need to be better than everybody else that particular year?
Right.
And I keep going back to, it's nice for us to say, well, they remind us of 07 or 11 or 13 or something like that. But are they good enough to beat all those good teams in the NFC? That's really what it comes down to. I don't think any of us are nervous about a divisional round. Then it's dealing with Pittsburgh. And then it's how do you match up with that team from the other side? So we could sit here and break down all of the championship teams over the years. But the bottom line is they've got to be better than whomever comes out of the NFC. And in theory, whoever's going to win the NFC this year is going to be a really good, battle-tested, and hardened football team.
All right, Andy Gresh joining us on the Sports Wrap every Wednesday. Stay warm, and hopefully you don't have to shovel too much tomorrow.
But dude, I got a snowblower. What are you kidding me? Shovel?
I thought a man of your stature would be...
What would be shoveling?
Yeah, come on.
No, I'm about efficiency. Haven't you learned by now? I want to get in and out like a robbery.
Snowblowing. All right, Gresh, we'll see.